This program is rated universal. Good for general watching.
Game On is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Well, two powerhouses in Oilers and TUC Cannons will be contention later on tonight in what should be an evenly poised encounter, just like it was in the reverse fixture in the National Basketball League. Just a three days to the start of the second outing in the Victoria Cup for the Rugby Cranes of Robert Sseguya, who will be, of course, giving us an insightful information about the forthcoming game, who will be featuring and who might not be featuring, how is the team prepared going into this affair against the Zambian side on match day two in the Victoria Cup tournament. Meanwhile, down in the UK, one Sandy Murray, who will, of course, be featuring in the mixed doubles and men's doubles, is rethinking over the decision he made about taking part in the men's singles in the forthcoming US Open 2019. Game On it is. The day is Wednesday, August 14th, the day is 2019. Proudly brought to you by 1xBet. I'm Nicholas Nobert Rubobi. Now, we are joined by the usual suspect in Brandon Simwe and the Rugby Cranes coach in Robert Sseguya, who's in the building, fresh from a defeat against Zimbabwe. Robert, how have you been? Kind of the face I expected in terms of the serious men look. Women business, a must win against Zambia. How is your life of late?
It has been a mix of life, you know, up and down. Mm. Not like you always get challenges from outsiders, challenges within. So how you deal with it comes the mindset. Mm. And how I present myself to the team also is reflecting the way the boys will come up after lose. So when you get into a loss somewhere, your mindset must be in a positive way, both to yourself and then to the team, so that the boys can also see there is hope after a loss.
Brian Asimi, good afternoon to you. Looking sharp as always. New shot in there, I can see, if I'm not mistaken. You're well yourself?
Yeah, I'm certainly doing amazing. Hope you're having yourself a lovely afternoon as well. It's good to see Coach Robert Sseguya here. I'm looking forward to a very insightful conversation and plenty of stuff we shall be discussing regarding the Uganda Rugby Cranes ahead of the big game this Saturday. That is down down at Chadondo against Zambia. So I'm really looking forward to the conversation and the rest of the stories as well.
Coach, there's a conversation going around, and that's, of course, the Rugby Cranes. At this point in time, lost 2-1-1. There is negative energy going around the entire circle of rugby, how the women's have fell down in South Africa, and now the 15th as well, having fell against Zimbabwe. It seems bad at this point in time. The Rugby Cranes find themselves in a very bad place going into this game against Zambia. It's a must win. I would imagine the message coming from you as coach to the players. Big game coming up against Zambia. What can the fans, the followers, expect come game day?
I will tell everybody that what you should be expected out of the team is a good performance this time. No mistakes. No room for mistakes anymore. We've had enough mistakes. Enough is enough. Everything has a limit. We've come to the limit.
Back-to-back defeats against, the defeat against Kenya kind of put the players in a bad place inside their heads mentally, because you want to think, having won the first leg in the Elgin Cup, they had a slim advantage going into the second leg at home, and for some reason tactically didn't go their way. You as a manager or as a head coach, you were frustrated because whatever you instructed them to do didn't fall in place. That bit of leadership was not there as well. Those nitty-gritty sometimes fail you and cost you the game. Going into this game against Zambia, you want to feel like you haven't left any stone untouched. In that regard, the players that will be going out there for match day know what is expected of them. Quickly give us a bit of a run from the game against Zimbabwe, the defeat against Kenya in leg two of the Elgin Cup, going into this encounter against Zambia.
You see, the mistakes that we made against Kenya at home, the return leg, we worked on them purely well, and they did not reflect in the Zimbabwe game. New mistakes came up in the Zimbabwe game.
Again.
But not the old mistakes. Then that put a question somewhere, somehow. How best can we make sure that we mitigate new mistakes coming ahead? So we've worked on that. We've seen that at least we need now new. You know, we've been having new players, versus the majority.
In every call-up that you have?
Yes. But this time around, I don't see myself calling up a new player during this game.
Coach, Out of curiosity, does every game have a different approach? Because again, time and again, you tend to stick to what works for you. As head coach, does every game have a different game approach? And even then, do you change it according to the opponent?
There is what they call the patterns of play, our structure, the general structure that we apply, no matter which opponent you're meeting. But again, that specific thing, how we look at you, how you attack, how you defend, then it changes.
Okay, from your end?
Yes. But there is a broader view. There is a broader view that this is how we play, this is how we defend.
So there's a tradition as to how you play.
Yes.
Interesting.
But, yeah, sure. But then again, going forward, like for Kenya, or when we're playing a team like Morocco, Algeria, very big, it has to change.
That's a change.
It has to change. Now, Zambia plays similarly, the same, like Uganda. They're a bit quick. They're a bit quick. And they play running game, like we play. So it has to change. We have to make sure that the team that we field today must be as quick or much more quicker and more physical so that we can meet them that way.
Brian, coach talks about no room for errors going into the game against Zambia. I would like to think that this message has been taken on by the players. They know what is at stake. And obviously for the 15s, a few areas tend to win them games, especially when you have strength in your scrum and also your defense as well. Saturday, Zambia is coming up. He mentions that Zambia have a similar style of play with the rugby cranes, something that from their point of view might work in their advantage, or even then in Zambia's advantage, because then you don't think both sides can easily match each other coming into game day down at Chadondo.
I like the way coach has put it. He talks about the fact that there is no room for mistakes going into this game. And if you noticed in the game against Zimbabwe, in the opening 10 minutes, the boys had already rallied in a couple of tries. They were trailing 19-0 inside the opening 10 minutes. In there, obviously, they had to play a bit of catch-up. Certainly, the brilliant kicking from Philip Okorach getting us back into that game. Even when we closed the gap to 19-12, we felt like there was a bit of a difference between us and the Zimbabwe team. And ultimately, they managed to end it 31-26. I think Aaron Oferov is one of the players he collected from the bench, replaced Paul Epilo. But even when he came on, if I'm not mistaken, he got sin binned, you know, in that particular game. So I think for me, discipline comes, you know, in handy for us. Certainly, the awareness from the boys as well. I do want to think that players like Desire Ayra are going to be super, you know, important for us. That is, if he does get to someone here, but he's already hinted that he's going to stick with the same team, which means that he should be in the side. The work rate that players like Paso Geda bring to the team, he's also a very crafty player. So for me, I think really, I do not want to despise Zambia, but for some reason, there's a school of thought that they're probably not as good as Zimbabwe. So that in itself probably gives us a bit of an edge. And I don't know how important it is the 16th man, which is the fan that will be coming out for the game, but he'll be telling us some of these things. But I'm very optimistic. This is our final home game before we go and play two games away from home, one at Zimbabwe, the other down in Lusaka to Zambia. So you want to think that we need to maximize playing at home this weekend, really.
There's an old say about you're as good as your last game, coach. When you look at that say, the defeat against Zimbabwe was very hurtful if compared to that against Kenya and Legs when we lost out on winning the Elgin Cup. But you'd want to think that from those last outings going into the next three outings, including the one of Saturday, what is the game plan like? Is it one game at a time because we have Zimbabwe coming through and then, of course, later on Zambia on the 31st of August?
Yeah, we're going to have a game at a time. We can't play two to three games ahead of us. We're going to to handle Zambia the way we're supposed to handle them.
Okay.
Then after that, remember, we've got a Zimbabwe game in our archive, so we shall look at it. And we've been reviewing our mistakes in Zimbabwe. Then we watch the game Zambia-Zimbabwe, so we see where we can use the weak points against them to make sure that we overcome. And he just said it about decision-making awareness. Of course, that's a game. Panic. You know, there was a lot of panic.
Panic mode.
Yeah.
From the players.
You see, when they had, you see, if a team gets very good preparation, for example, Zimbabwe was playing Currie Cup in South Africa. It works on the player's mental. You, what have you had?
Nothing.
For example, what have you had when you have an exam?
Preparation kind of.
Exactly. When you play Currie Cup, even your mental, the way you think, you see, you've been playing up here. That's why Zimbabwe managed to go and beat Kenya in Kenya. Because their mental is up here. They have been playing these teams in South Africa, super teams. So the preparation, when they had, they have been playing Currie Cup. And they were saying, for us, what have you been playing?
How do you manage that? How do you manage, or how do you get that mental weakness out of the players' heads? Because again, those are some of the key areas that tend to win you games, especially in rugby.
It's about telling the player that what they're doing there is what we're doing here. Mm-hmm. Yeah. If for example, we have a test game between ourselves, mm-hmm. give it your all. Mm-hmm. Give it your all. It will match like you're actually playing maybe Cheetahs in South Africa, maybe you're playing another Vodacom team. Mm-hmm. So it's about preparing them mentally, giving them a new mindset. Yeah, guys, you know, they're trained hard to this level. These boys, these are their texts. So if it's this level of conditioning, let's also try to hit them so there will be no difference.
Defensively, we've been caught on the breaks. There's been a few gaps that we're seeing against Zimbabwe, against Kenya as well. That is an area I think you've managed to seal and fix. I had to ask about the changes that you'll be making going into the game against Zambia. I'll leave that to you, of course, knowing that it's protocol to be observed in regards to the team formation. But quickly, I'd like to pick your mind on the lady rugby cranes, Edgar Lemeringa, not having a very handsome outing down in South Africa. Succumbing to a thumping last Friday against the Springboks women's team, 9-5, going into the game yesterday, 37 again against the Kenya Lionesses. It feels like the same old mistakes keep coming back again and again. But he was quite optimistic that he managed to, he was impressed by the outing despite the result down in South Africa against Kenya.
Yeah, you see, I'm not in to support a loss in any way. No, I don't.
But a loss is a loss. See,
yeah, a loss is a loss, good or bad. There's no good or bad, it's always a loss. Mm-hmm. So he's doing a good job. After the ladies were off a period of time, you see, if you're not in active competition, you can't perform at a good level. Even when you have a very good coach, mm-hmm. it will take you some time. Yeah. He's building slowly. Today is a learning curve for the Lady Cranes.
Even against the same side that beat you up in the recent Women's Elgin Cup?
Yeah, I'll tell you an example. If you watch the game, first half it was 5-0. Mm-hmm. 3-0. Mm-hmm. It came. That's when maybe now.
Hell broke loose for them.
That's where now experience comes in, mm-hmm. comes to play with the people on pitch. Not with the coach, but with the people on pitch.
The players.
Yeah. So you see now that worked. Kenya has been playing many games, international games, mm-hmm. Uganda girls. Their build up game is a match against Kenya. Their second test game is again a match mm-hmm. against Kenya. Another one is South Africa. So this is how you prepare. Now they have been off about 4 years, Uganda ladies not playing, mm-hmm. Kenya has been playing. Mm-hmm. That's the difference. Now let's see what will happen.
Brian, how much of that can be taken as, or can they take in as the Lady Rugby Cranes? Because you want to think, I mean, you know, beating against Kenya, yes, lessons learned going into the game, even prior to the game itself, Edgar was actually very, specific about how much they've learned from those mistakes in the previous games, how much they managed to learn even then against the Springboks. So how much of that do you think they can actually feed off going into the next game? Because yes, we know it was their first time playing at that stage down in South Africa.
I think for me, the bright side, regardless of the two losses they've had against Kenya and South Africa, has got to be the fact that it's a platform. Mm. It's giving them the exposure that they need. These girls are going out there and playing against teams that you could argue are probably a little bit ahead of us in terms of, you know, the exposure they picked up in terms of the technical ability. So that in itself means that it's a learning curve for the girls. Mm. And given the fact that this squad was just assembled a couple of months going into, you know, the World Cup and obviously this particular tournament, you have a sense that there's not been that gelling. The cohesiveness as a team has not been there. Mm-hmm. And it's actually shown in some of these particular fixtures. But I'll fancy our chances against Madagascar this weekend mm-hmm. with the hope that the girls can go out there and save a bit of face, probably get us a bit of a result. Probably one of the things that the coach Edgar Lemeringa talked about was that the first half was better. They tried to cut out the mistakes they had, you know, had in the game against South Africa. Mm-hmm. They tried to play a little bit more solid, especially in the defense as well. However, in the second half, it was a whole completely different ball game. Mm-hmm. The Kenyans simply ran riot, ran in a couple of tries before we knew it, they were actually running off with the result. So for me, I think that consistency over the course of the first and the second half is always going to be important for the girls.
Coach, a win against Zambia before we go into the other third game against Zimbabwe. Reality happening this weekend?
No doubt.
No doubt.
We're going to leave no stone unturned.
All right, there you have it. Of course, Coach Robert Sseguya with the Rugby Cranes out to secure their first win in the ongoing Victoria Cup as they face the Zambian side, who will be, of course, out to play their second game, just like it was for the Rugby Cranes against Zimbabwe. It will not be the case this very Saturday, says Coach and the entire rugby fraternity. And we shall be behind them, rooting for them in Chadondo this very weekend as they encounter the Zambians. We'll take a small breather when we get back. News has it that the UPL fixtures for 2019-2020 have been released, and of course the Fiesa team has also been flagged off by the head of state in His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports.
Game on is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.